need to make a break.
Channel. My name is Vanessa. I make videos about music, health and productivity based on my knowledge as a classical musician and full-time music student. In today's video, I'm going to show you three ideas for your breaks in your study or practicing sessions. Whether you are using the Pomodoro method or not, breaks are essential for your body and the goal for every break should be to make you feel ready to go to work again. These three ideas are perfect because they do not require you to change clothes, you do not sweat, and you do not have to have any special equipment, and they are very, very simple to do. The first, and in my opinion, the most effective technique is the constructive rest or lie down. This position comes from the Alexander technique, which is very well known among musicians and actors. The only two things you need are a clean surface to lay down and a book. When I'm practicing at home, I normally have my exercise mat on the floor, but you can do it also on the carpet or on the bar floor if you feel comfortable doing it there. You start by lying down with your knees bent and your feet flat on the floor. The purpose of the book is to support your head. There should be enough height under your head that your neck can relax. So you can use one or two books, depends what is comfortable for you. Your elbow should be bent and your hand should rest comfortable on your torso. And while lying in this position, I feel that my body relaxes a lot, and especially when you sit most of the day, like me practicing on my harp or working on my computer, this position really, really relieves your back. The second position is also a lying down position. It comes from the primaristic, which is a knowledge and teaching of the sensory motor development of humans. It is based on the laws of neurophysiology and was developed by a children's doctor and his wife, who was a physiotherapist. For this position, you lie down on the floor again, but this time on your stomach. You fold your hands in front of your head so that you can rest on them with your forehead. Your legs are hip-width apart and your feet tilt outwards. The third idea I'm going to show you is my favorite breathing exercise. So when you're doing breathing exercises, it's very helpful that you combine breathing with movement. This can be a really small movement, for example, of your finger, or like a big movement of your arm. Personally, I like to sit cross-legged, but you can do the exercise in any other position. So my hands are resting on my legs, and for every inhalation, I move now my index finger upwards, and with every exhalation, I move my index finger downwards. And after 5 minutes doing this, I feel very, very relaxed, but not tired, which is really important if you would like to go to work again. And it's just so simple and so helpful that it's amazing. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any other ideas, please let me know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel that you don't miss any further videos. And I'm looking forward to see you in my next video. Bye!